and thank you for joining us tonight for our online Maundy-Thursday service of darkness. At this time, Cheryl McMurtry is going to lead us in our call to worship.
Let us hold fast to the faith we confess.
For we have a great high priest who has gone into the very presence of God, Jesus, the Son of God.
Our high priest is not one who cannot feel sympathy with our weaknesses.
On the contrary, we have a high priest who is tempted in every way that we are, but did not sin.
Let us be brave, then, and come forward to God's throne, where there is grace.
There we will receive mercy and find grace to help us just when we need it.
Please join us in singing Break Thou the Bread of Life.
John chapter 13, 31 to
35. When he was gone, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man is glorified, and God is glorified in him. If God is glorified in him, God will glorify the Son in himself, and will glorify him at once. My children, I will be with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and just as I told the Jews, so I tell you now, where I am going, you cannot come. A new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another."
Friends, as we prepare to partake of communion together, I would invite you to join with us in singing our communion hymn, "Let Us Break Bread Together."
Online, I would like to encourage you to take the bread that you have and
when everybody has their bread ready, I will simply remind you of Jesus' words. This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And now those of us who are here in the sanctuary, I would encourage you to peel back your paper very carefully. And those of you who are worshiping with us at home, I would encourage you to take the cup that you have, and if you would like, you can hold up your cup as we hold up our cup together. This is my blood, which is shed for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Amen. Well, friends, at this time, I would invite you to join us in our next hymn. At this time, we're going to sing the first verse of What Wondrous Love Is This.
Then Jesus told them, "This very night you will all fall away on account of me. For it is written, 'I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.' But after I have risen, I will go ahead of you into Galilee." Now Peter replied, "Even if all fall away on account of you, I never will." "Truly I tell you," Jesus answered, "this very night, before the rooster crows, you will disown me 3 times. But Peter declared, "Even if I have to die with you, I will never disown you." And all the other disciples said the same.
Thank you. And Jesus said to his disciples, "Sit here while I pray." He took Peter, James, and John along with him, and he became to be deeply distressed and troubled. "My soul is overwhelmed with sorrow to the point of death," he said to them. "Stay here and keep watch." Going a little farther, he fell to the ground and prayed that if it was possible, the hour might pass from him. "Abba, Father," he said, "everything is possible for you. Take this cup from me, yet not what I will, but what you will." Then he returned to his disciples and found them sleeping. "Simon," he said to Peter, "are you asleep? Couldn't you keep watch for 1 hour? Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak." Once more he went away and prayed the same. When he came back, he again found them sleeping because their eyes were heavy. They did not know what to say to him. Returning the third time, he said, "Are you still sleeping and resting? Enough. The hour has come. Look, the Son of Man is delivered into the hands of sinners."
While he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. With him was a large crowd armed with swords and clubs, sent from the chief priests and the elders of the people. Now the betrayer had arranged a signal with them: "The one I kiss is the man. Arrest him." Going at once to Jesus, Judas said, "Greetings, Rabbi," and kissed him. Jesus replied, "Do what you came for, friend." Then the men stepped forward, seized Jesus, and arrested him. With that, one of Jesus' companions reached for his sword, drew it out, and struck the servant of the high priest, cutting off his ear. "Put your sword back in its place," Jesus said to him, "for all who draw the sword will die by the sword."
Disown me 3 times. And he went outside and wept bitterly. and went back inside the palace, summoned Jesus and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" "Is that your own idea?" Jesus asked, "or did others talk to you about me?" "Am I a Jew?" Pilate replied. "Your own people and chief priests handed you over to me. What is it you have done?" Jesus said, "My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest by the Jewish leaders. But now, my kingdom is from another place." "You are a king then," said Pilate. Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. In fact, the reason I was born and came into this world is to testify to the truth. Everyone on the side of truth listens to me." "What is truth?" retorted Pilate.
The soldiers led Jesus away into the palace, that is the praetorium, and called together the whole company of soldiers. They put a purple robe on him, then twisted together a crown of thorns and sat it on him. And they began to call out to him, "Hail, King of the Jews!" Again and again they struck him on the head with a staff and spit on him. Falling on their knees, they paid homage to him, and when they had mocked him, they took off the purple robe and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. Please join us in singing when I survey the wondrous cross.
Let's pray. God, we are grateful for the opportunity that we've had tonight to journey back to the upper room 2,000 years ago, to experience the heartbreak, to experience the intimacy. God, we pray that you would help us to be inspired by the example of our Savior, the courage. God, we ask that you would go with us now as we continue to prayerfully consider Jesus' actions that would lead him to the cross and ultimately to the empty tomb when we come together again on Easter Sunday morning. God, we pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. And now, friends, for our benediction, as we go from here, let us go knowing that no greater love has anyone than this, than they lay down their life for their friends. Amen.